One. All right. Nate Patterson, Solo Productions. We're here at the Central Library in Springfield, Mass. for the C3 police meeting that happens every Tuesday at 11 o'clock in the Springfield Library. We got a lot of people coming through. Wow, this place backed up really fast. We're going to go to the meeting, and I'll see you on the flip side.
Thank you. Is there anyone here for the first time? Oh, thank you for coming. Welcome, you. Glad you're here. So I'm just going to tell you a little bit how the meeting runs. We do a police report out, so they tell us an incident that happened in the past week. Then we give a facilitator report out, the chair report, and then I give a report, and then the trooper. The trooper tells about the essential goals, and he's here, and now we have someone in here gives the essential goals of the meeting, and then we go around the room and each person tells who they are, whether they're a resident or what organization they represent, and a little bit about what they do. If they have anything in the community to report, whether good or bad, they report it at that time. If there's something that they want investigated, that's the time to report it, and the officers will come back and follow up with an update. If there's nothing to report, they say nothing to report, we move on to the next person. All at one-off activities or events, that's only going to happen one time or maybe three times, we hold to the end so everyone can get around them and say who they are. Okay? So with that, we'll start with the police report.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Officer Walter. I've only got one arrest. This arrest took place on the 28th at about 5:44 a.m. The charges are as follows. It's going to be 3 counts of home invasion, one count of malicious damage to a motor vehicle, another count of malicious destruction of property over $250, witness intimidation, B&E to a building, and another count of destruction of property over $250 and resisting arrest. This incident first started on Berkeley Street. A woman woke up, heard a noise, and there was a male in her house with her hallway. She recognized the male to be her brother. He had a knife in hand and he was kind of aggressive towards her. She ran back and told her, if it was her husband, that the individual was in the hallway with a knife. Later on, they ran back and called police. The subject was angry and started throwing things about. He eventually fled once they called up the Chicago police. After that, there was another incident I believe Locust Street. Yes, on Logan Street, where the same individual tried to break into another apartment. There was a commotion at the door. The person in the apartment heard a commotion at the door. He ran to the door and saw someone trying to break make his way into the apartment door. He clenched, the door closed. The subject then began kicking the door, but he was unsuccessful at getting in. It gave out a description of an individual. Subject was a black male, about 32 years old, muscular. He was about 5'8", 165 pounds, and had long dreadlocks. He was wearing black shirt, black pants, and blue gloves.
To speak to me, and your name is?
My name is Chris Carter.
Hi, Chris.
I'm a peer health advocate for the Mason Square Health Task Force, which is essentially an outreach program where the youth, they go out, they give people talks about health awareness and kind of help them get the places and resources that will help them better themselves within the community.
Okay.
So it's usually to help people around here in Mason Square, but it can be used to help anyone in the city.
So how does someone get in touch with you if they have their concerns and they want you to speak at a program or maybe at a school or at a function?
We go to a lot of events, and we give our names out in our cards and contact information. If you have any events, you can contact me, and I could tell my supervisor. And we
so you'll leave me a card?
Essentially, yeah.
Absolutely. Or write it down.
Right.
I want to thank you so much for being here, and thank you. And I look forward to seeing you next week.
Right. All right. Have a great day.
Thank you. Okay.